Hey guys, it's Artcast 368, I think. Jeff Lafferty, just sitting here drawing a Princess Leia piece. And I had a question from a guy this week, just kind of talking about, like, what's the resources out there to, like, learn how to draw? So I'm drawing a Princess Leia little painting today. And I imagine I'll put it on eBay pretty soon. And I was going to do like a really cool like speed paint and do it all up with some music and stuff and make it really awesome and kind of like a tribute piece since Carrie Fisher died. But I'm having all kinds of trouble with my equipment. My computer's down, and so I'm filming this on my wife's computer with my webcam. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to edit the video that I wanted to edit. I think this might be more of a one-shot kind of video where I just sit and talk and do the best I can. Back to the question, like what kind of resources are out there to learn how to draw? And I might be a little outdated in this because I learned how to draw a long time ago. But there's a few things that stand out in my mind, especially for younger artists, that I think would probably be good for them even today. And one of them is a book called Drawing from the Right Side of the Brain. I know that I've mentioned that book before, but it's a great book. And the reason I feel that it's a great book is those kids that like want to take their art to the next level when they're like around, you know, 12 or 13 or 14 years old. You know, like you're already good at like drawing monsters and monster trucks or, you know, gunfights, or you got your character with like, you know, a million blades called Dark Blade or something, you know. And everything's really cool, and you know, your friends think you can draw really good. But then you want to like take it up to that next level. You're like, well, how does, you know, like just fill in the blank, or one of your, you know, favorite artists or whatever, how does whoever, Jeff Maricola, do it, you know? How does he make it look that good? Or like James Gurney, he's another really good one that's on YouTube here. Or, I don't know. I'm trying to think of like popular artists like right now, and I really can't think of any because all I ever think about is like the popular artists when I was a kid, and because that's the stuff I loved, you know? But like whoever it is that you love, and you're like, how do I draw like that guy, you know? Well, he's got, you know, he's got that experience on you. He's got, or she, you know, they've got a lot of tricks and techniques that you haven't discovered yet because you're only 14 and they're probably like 40, you know? So they were in your shoes at one point, and what you can look at is hopeful as they got better and better and better and became, you know, who they are. And they did that from like studying and doing a ton of reading and looking at other artists, you know. You can look at other artists and just try to like backwards engineer how they did what they do. You know what I mean? I did that when I was younger. I was enamored with Frank Frazetta and Bernie Wrightson. And I'd spend hours and hours like looking at their pieces, trying to figure out like how the heck do they draw like that, you know? And even though that can kind of like sometimes push your work in that direction, and you can kind of become a little bit of a clone sometimes, you know, you learn like invaluable stuff. And as time goes on and you find more and more artists that you like, and you find like stuff that you just like on your own, you'll naturally like move away and kind of like get your own style and that kind of stuff. But back to that book, because that's not, you know, the lady who wrote the book, she's not like an artist that I'm enamored with and, you know, thought, oh my God, I gotta draw like her. What was just good about that book is it gave you like really basic directions on drawing like realistic and drawing from reference and that kind of stuff. And whether that's going to be part of your style or not later on, it's just good to know it. You know what I mean? It's good to like understand it, because it just gives you like one more resource where you can pull from and just get better, you know? That was an awesome book. And then another book that, you know, I don't know if anybody can find it. I actually do have the copy of this one. This is one that my high school art teacher gave me. It's called The Zen of Seeing. Drawing as Meditation. And I've talked about this book too. This is this guy's art. Here's scribbly and watercolor washy and all this kind of stuff. But, oh, that's interesting. A couple little pictures in there. But, the thing about this book that's really awesome is that it teaches you to, I don't know if it teaches you, but it wakes you up to the idea of like I don't know, like what I would call like a drawing trance. And it's kind of what happens to me when I'm drawing, you know, is I go into this sort of like zone, not so much when I'm talking to you guys. That's the only time it doesn't quite happen. But in some ways it does, because my hands and stuff are moving. They're doing their own thing. And I'm talking to you with like a different part of my brain. But it's tied into that whole right side of the brain, left side of the brain kind of thing. And it's when you're like just zoning out in a way. You know what I mean? Have you ever like sat around and drawed or painted or did anything and just kind of like lost time and kind of looked up and suddenly it was like, an you know, 2 or 3 hours later and you're like, whoa, what happened, you know? And you were just inside your own like, I don't want to say inside your own head, because that's not even what I'm talking about, but you're almost like in a trance, you know? And so in a way almost like meditating, but you know, I don't meditate and stuff, so that's probably not, in my opinion, a good comparison of it. But it's like you're just looking, you're not thinking, you know what I mean? You're not thinking about drawing, you're just looking and you're just doing, and you're just letting it happen. You're letting your like hand move the pencil, and and just letting it happen, you know? Which is like, I think the key to like so much of it. But that book, you know, I mean, I think I read it at a time in my life, because I read it when I was probably 15, maybe. Probably was 15. Maybe 16, actually. And it just kind of filled in some gaps, because it was like the perfect time for me to sort of stop thinking and stop trying so hard and just let it happen, you know. And in that book, you know, they really talk about just seeing and just looking, not technique and not move your pencil this way or move your pencil that way. Just look, you know, just like shut your mind off. Don't think about what your hand's doing and just look at what's there. Other than that, I would say, I would go back to that other thing I was kind of talking about a minute ago, which is, to study like artists that you admire. I did a lot of that, maybe too much really, but I think that, like, you know, it gave me a good grasp and a good education in art, you know, or in the kind of art that I liked. Not necessarily fine art or anything, but just the kind of stuff I wanted to do. And then, you know, try to not make that too narrow. By that I mean, you know, like study even the people you hate and stuff, you know. When I was younger, like a lot of people, I didn't care for modern art. I thought it was a scam, and I thought, you know, these guys can't draw and they just make all kinds of money for splattering paint and stuff like that. But later on in life, I began to appreciate it. I didn't think that it was like unbelievably hard, and I didn't, you know, think that it was like so much better than realism and all this other kind of stuff. But I started to appreciate it for what it was, you know. And, you know, a striking image, you know. That's what a lot of that stuff is. And it's not labored over, you know. It's spontaneous and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, it's like, as you get older, you know, your tastes broaden, I guess. Or sometimes they do. Sometimes I think you get more narrow-minded, but... I think that's a good thing too, you know. It's just kind of keep yourself open to like all the kind of stuff, even the stuff you hate sometimes, because that can teach you lessons also. So I'm gonna wrap it up because my voice is just about ready to go. Sorry, I have a cold this week, and I'm gonna need to, like I said, edit this dang video on Tanya's computer, and. I don't know how long that's going to take, so thanks you guys for watching. Check out Patreon. I'm doing the extended cuts, and every one of those is just heck of a lot more of me talking and drawing and just the same kind of thing. Usually try to get at least 30 minutes, and you know, sometimes it's 40, 50 minutes extra. And that's it. See you guys next Friday.